Jay Boughton's family saw justice for his murder today when Jamal Smith was convicted on all charges for the deadly shooting on Highway 169. While this brings Boughton's loved ones some relief, they still have a lot of healing ahead. Devon Rahming shares what happened in court and their reaction tonight.
Today, the jury found Evil guilty on all three counts.
After about 16 hours of deliberations, a jury delivered three guilty verdicts to Jamal Smith today, including one for first-degree murder for the shooting of youth baseball coach Jay Boughton on Highway 169. Boughton's brother-in-law, Stephen, spoke on behalf of the family after Thursday's verdict.
It's not a celebratory mood that the family has. We don't get Jay back. But with that said, the amazement of the Boughton family, the strength, the courage, staying in the light, Jay's light, God's light, their own light, has been truly amazing this past year.
Boughton was shot and killed during a road rage incident in Plymouth last July after leaving a baseball game. His then 15-year-old son, Harrison, was sitting in the passenger seat and witnessed the tragedy.
And today is just a step in the right direction. But Harrison Nomley and I have a long way to go without Jay.
Decked out in yellow.
My son picked yellow. That's light.
Boughton's wife, Kristen, spoke to the motto tattooed on her arm, "Stay in the light." It's what she says has guided them through this last year.
The light is peace. The light is strength. The light is courage. The light keeps us from becoming angry. So stay in the light is a must.
A must made a little easier, she says, now that justice has been served.
I want to thank so many people for their thoughts and prayers and to ask them to continue to pray and think for us or think about us.
Now, Smith will face a life sentence on the first-degree murder charge, but will be eligible for parole after a 30-year sentence. That date, though, for the sentencing hasn't been set. And in the last half hour, Smith's attorney released a statement saying, in part, "It is cruel and unusual punishment to give such a person a life sentence who never intended to kill anyone." They go on to say, quote, "We are examining the issue of selective prosecution." Lauren.
All right, Devon, thank you.